Can stars become planets? To the professional astronomers, the stars are part of a huge natural laboratory, one of enormous extremes. Light years away in the heart of the cosmos, stars provide a testbed to theories and observations on behavior of matter, which cannot be comprehended through on-ground observations. Our star, the Sun, is no exception. It is halfway through its 10 billion year lifespan, and it too will fade away. There's still a lot of research going on as we speak about stars and fates of stars. Are all stars familiar? Do all of them have the same or seemingly same fate? What happens to stars when they die? In today's video, we're going to discuss a rather uncommon fate that some stars meet. Can stars become planets? Before we move on to this unusual topic, let's discuss more about stars and planets. If you haven't already watched our detailed video about stars or how do stars die, make sure to watch it till the end to completely comprehend this topic. Let's recap about planets, stars, and the fate of stars. Before the space revolution, planets were hardly more than dots in the sky, which revealed blurred details when seen through a telescope. Now, thanks to surveys by diligent space probes, planets are real new worlds with mountains, valleys, volcanoes, ring systems, and vast entourages of moons. The temperature of the surface of planets can vary depending on its location from a star. Planets are formed around newly formed stars when gases and tiny particles come together, spinning under the influence of their own gravity. The large planets further undergo more collisions, throwing debris in space, further forming more planets. Stars, on the other hand, are giant balls made up of gas and dust, which can have surface temperatures varying to a large extent, depending upon the amount of gas utilized to form the star. The hottest star category being type O star and the coolest being type M stars. Stars are born inside a solar nebula, a large cloud of gas and dust. They are formed in large numbers. They are initially called protostars, which further form a cluster of stars, like the Toucan 47 globular cluster. The fate of a star varies depending upon its mass. Stars like our Sun belong to a category of stars known as main sequence stars. These stars continue their fusion reactions in core for billions of years. During the end of their lives, they cool down gradually and expand further to form giants and supergiants. They remain in the phase of giants for about a billion years. During this time period, the star converts helium to lithium via nuclear fusion reactions, and further on converts lithium to beryllium and so on until iron. When main sequence stars exhaust all of their fuel, they are left with a dense iron core. Further, the gravity of the star weakens and they are unable to hold their outermost layers. Hence, they end up losing their outer layers in supernovas and form a white dwarf star centered around the stellar remains of the dead star. White dwarfs are not ideal to be classified as a planet. The main sequence stars with mass greater than 1.4 times that of the Sun end up in a supernova, which again results in formation of planetary objects such as black holes, neutron stars, or white dwarfs. Such objects see no possibility of becoming a planet. Now the question arises, can any star turn into a planet during any particular phase of its life? As we couldn't find the possibility of that happening throughout the lifestyle of an ideal star, or are there possibly more classifications of stars? The answer to our question is simple and lies within planetary nebulas, the birthplace of stars. Main sequence stars have no possibility of turning into a planet by any means. However, there is another type of star, or better to say, a failed star, the brown dwarf. Many do not consider it as a star, as it failed to sustain a nuclear reaction. So what makes the brown dwarf unique? Are brown dwarfs habitable? Not all protostars are able to become stars. Some blow away during their formation, some are eaten away by other protostars, and some simply fail to start nuclear reactions. Now imagine, what if there was a massive protostar which wasn't massive enough compared to other stars? Such a protostar wouldn't be able to generate enough gravitational field at its center to sustain nuclear fusion. Hence, it simply stays as it is, unlike other protostars, which compete against one another to become a star. Here the brown dwarf comes in. Brown dwarfs cannot fuse hydrogen. The main fusion reaction supporting brown dwarfs is that of heavy water or deuterium, which is relatively very rare compared to abundance of hydrogen in space. Hence, brown dwarfs exhaust their nuclear fuel early in their lives and cool down. Such an object would simply radiate all of its energy into space, gradually cooling down over billions of years, and would then be a dead rocky mass. In astronomical terms, such objects are referred to as brown dwarfs, the non-igniting stars. Brown dwarfs are not actually brown in color. They appear red through infrared imaging as they emit very low light rays. Brown dwarfs are still massive enough to have planets around them in their orbits. Hence, similar to a regular star, planets revolve around brown dwarfs, making it look like a bunch of planets revolving around a giant planet. An average brown dwarf has a mass of 20 times that of Jupiter. In the early 20th century, a lot of research papers were being published on the discovery of new stars and planets. In 1963, Dr. Shiv S. Kumar, a professor at University of Virginia, predicted the presence of brown dwarfs, or black stars, as referred to by them. They made the prediction based upon calculation of minimum mass required by a protostar to become a star. However, it was not until 1995 that astronomers successfully detected the presence of brown dwarfs. Brown dwarfs are difficult to observe as they emit very faint light and infrared radiation, which were difficult to detect in early times. Hence, they remain cool and undetectable throughout their life. Till date, only about 4,000 brown dwarfs have been discovered. But let's not forget the fact that brown dwarfs are the failed stars. Hence, even the smallest brown dwarf discovered was twice as massive as Jupiter. However, there's still a possibility of even white dwarfs becoming a planet. In fact, every star in this universe, which will become a white dwarf in the near future, will become a planet one day. Well, don't be surprised when I say even our sun will become a planet, a real massive planet, although the gravity would still be extreme to such an extent that it won't be habitable for a living mechanism to survive, we still can classify it in the category of planets. Let us go forward in the far future. After a septillion years, that is after 10 billion trillion years, our universe will undergo an era known as the degenerate era. The rate of expansion of the universe during this time would be faster than the speed of light, hence making it impossible for light from one cosmological body to reach another. As we know, the universe is expanding and will keep on expanding. By this time, we all would have been flung apart in space in dark isolation from other galaxies. All the presently existing stars would have been dead by that time, and the newest generation of stars would have become white dwarfs. Even the white dwarfs would have cooled down to such an extent in space that they could barely emit any more heat or light, ending their lives by becoming a brown dwarf, a giant planetary object radiating little to no heat. There are endless possibilities to this question, awaiting more research and discoveries. While we might not know the answer to these questions right now, as we still have a long way to go, we may never know the answers to all questions, as the fate of our universe is the most mysterious amongst all.